In this video, I'll share some video tips and settings for the Lumix G9 camera. Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto. I'm a photographer and a Lumix ambassador. And in this video, I'm gonna share some video tips and settings for the Lumix G9 camera. I've been using the G9 pretty extensively for video for a long time now, and I hope these settings and tips will help you if you also use the G9 for video a lot, like me. Almost every time I go out and shoot outside for this YouTube channel, I'll take the G9 as my video camera for the following reasons. First of all, the image quality in general is very good in video. And this can shoot 4K 10-bit footage. And this can also shoot 4K 50 and 60p without any crop. The image stabilizer is excellent and it has dual card slots. However, there are also a couple of downsides, of course. There's a recording limit for all the normal footage. It's 29 minutes and 59 seconds. And if you shoot 50 or 60p, then the limit is 10 minutes. Those have never been any issue for me, but some people complain about them. And I can understand that in some situations, those limits can be a problem. But if you need longer recording times on a regular basis, then I suggest you just get another camera, because then this is obviously not the right camera for that kind of video shooting. And my first tip is a software tip, kind of software tip. Let me put the camera away. I highly recommend you to get the SFU1 software upgrade software key. This will allow you to shoot Vlog L photo style, which is the really flat, most gradable footage that you can get out of your G9. And this will also activate the waveform monitor, which is the best way to evaluate exposure in video. I highly recommend this. This is only something like 100 euros or dollars, even less if you can find a special offer or something, and it's well worth the money. And I also have an affiliate link down below for this, so if you're interested to purchase this, please use the link down below and you'll support my channel at the same time. And the next one is a hardware tip, and it's about the best video lenses. My most used video lens when I'm outside is the Leica 12-60mm f2.8 f4. This is an excellent all-around lens, and I just set it at f4 and treat it like a constant f4 lens, and it's just about the optimal aperture for most footage. The range and reach of this lens is excellent also, especially if you consider the relatively compact size of the lens. And you can also extend the reach a little bit if you use the actual pixels on the sensor when you shoot video. And you can do that by going to the menu, the camera, video camera menu, and on the fourth page there's this X teleconverter choice. Go there and activate that, and the camera will use the actual pixels on the sensor, and you will gain a little bit of extra reach without hardly any image quality penalty. The only real downside with this lens is that it's not really optimal for low light video shooting because of the maximum aperture, which is from 2.8 to f4. And if you shoot a lot in low light conditions, my ultimate recommendation is the Leica 10-25mm f1.7, which is mounted on my GH5S at the moment. This is really a superb lens for video shooting, but it's also really, really expensive, and I can't recommend this unless you shoot video a lot or pretty much every day. Then this lens is really worth the money. But if you only sometimes need a low light video lens, then I recommend the Lumix 25mm f1.7 standard lens. It's very affordable and it does a really good job for video in low light conditions. And I do have affiliate links also for the lenses down below. So if you decide to purchase some of these lenses, please use the links down below. And then I have one more hardware tip, and that is a variable ND filter. Get one of these and you can control the exposure with this, and you don't have to touch your camera settings at all. Because in video, it's important to keep at least the shutter speed the same all the time. And preferably, you should have so-called 180 degree shutter angle, which means if you shoot at 24p, your shutter speed should be ideally 1/48th of a second, but 1/50th of a second is also fine. And if you want to use a little bit wider aperture, like f4 or even wider, and if you shoot in bright daylight, you just can't do without some kind of ND filter on your lens. And this variable ND filter also gives you a stepless exposure control. My filter is Nisi Pro Nano Vario ND filter. And this is from 1.5 to 5 stops. And that 5 stops is barely strong enough on a bright sunny day. So if you shoot a lot in bright sunny conditions, or if you live somewhere where it's often really bright and sunny, then I suggest you get something a little bit stronger than this. But for me, this has worked really well because here where I live in Finland, we don't have those really super bright sunny days that often, only in summer times and not every day, even in summer. But I can highly, highly recommend this Nisi Pro Nano Vario ND filter because it doesn't ruin your image quality, it doesn't soften your picture, and even the color cost is minimal. Some very cheap variable ND filters will soften your picture, and they may also have a very strong color cost. I do have an affiliate link also for this filter down below, so if you if you want to purchase it, please use my link down below. And if you buy one of these, I recommend you to buy one that fits to your largest filter thread. Like mine is 77mm, then I just have this step down or step up rings that I use for my smaller lenses, because these are not cheap, so you don't want to buy one for each lens. And next I have some camera settings. First is the operation lock. I recommend you to use that, especially if you're shooting video, because it's very, very easy to accidentally change some of the settings while you are handling the camera. And if you change some of the settings, you might ruin a lot of video footage because of that. It's very easy, for example, to change the shutter speed, and you don't necessarily realize it until after you have shot like several minutes of footage that might not be useful because of that. You can activate the operation lock if you go to the, turn the camera on, if you go to the custom spanner menu, choose operation and there operation lock settings, and there make sure all the options are on: the cursor, joystick, touchscreen and dials. When everything is on and you turn on the operation lock, then you can't accidentally change any of the settings, even if you move the dials or press the buttons. And it has saved a lot of footage, at least for me. I have programmed the operation lock on the upper right button, right next to the lens mount here. And It's very easy to turn it on and off whenever I need. And then some camera settings that I use whenever I shoot video on the Lumix G9. First of all, the shutter speed. I already mentioned earlier in this video that so-called 180 degree shutter angle is the best for all kinds of general video footage. And it means that if you're shooting at 25 frames per second, your shutter speed should be 1/50th of a second. If you shoot 30 frames per second, then use 1/60th of a second, and so on. And if you change your frame rate, always remember to change your shutter speed to correspond to that frame rate that you have chosen. But it's very, very easy to forget to change the shutter speed whenever you change the frame rate. So I recommend you to use the custom memory settings to C1, C2, and C3 and program some of your most frequently used frame rates there so that the shutter speed and the frame rate match nicely together. And then whenever you need to change your frame rate, you just move the dial to C1, C2, or whatever position, and you never have to worry about the wrong shutter speed anymore. And then, which video quality should you use? Okay, my most used video quality is 10-bit 422, 24 frames per second, and Vlog L photo style. But if you don't like to grade your video footage, you just want your footage to look great straight out of camera, then I recommend you to experiment, shoot some test footage, and see which photo style looks best to you and which works best for your kind of shooting and workflow. But if you like to grade your footage, then the Vlog L 10-bit is the way to go, definitely. But what if you use your camera for both video and photography? And then you customize your camera for video shooting, then it might not be optimal for photography anymore because some of the buttons and dials may not work well for photography. There are a couple of solutions that may work for you. And the first one is for those who don't shoot video very often. Then I recommend you to use the custom memory settings to C1, C2 and C3 and program some of the video settings on these custom memories, and then you can very quickly and easily turn on the video settings and film the video you need, and then go back to shoot photography. Just turn the dial back to some of the photography modes. But if you use your G9 a lot also for video, and you have sometimes you have a video day and sometimes you have a photography day, then I recommend you to save your video settings on a memory card and save also your photo settings on a memory card. And whenever you have a video day, then you just insert the card and load the video settings on your camera. And whenever you have a photo day, insert the other card to your camera and load the photo settings on the camera, and then the camera always has the optimal best settings for whatever you want to do with the camera. I hope this video helps you to set up your Lumix G9 for video shooting. And here's my other video on how to set up the dials and buttons on your Lumix camera. And if you like this video, you can also buy me a cup of coffee. There's a link down below for that. Thank you so much for joining in, and I'll see you in the next one.